Now legislative assembly, before I going to explain this, once again I explain about the governor and the chief minister. The governor makes the chief minister and other members of the cabinet take oath of loyalty to constitution and of scarcity. He calls meetings of the legislative assembly and also postpones them. He grant financial draft to be presented in the assembly. When we draft pass with majority is signed by the governor, it becomes a binding law. He takes out ordinance in emergency. He appoints magistrates, judges of the courts working under the authority of the High Court. Now, Chief Minister is the administrative head of the ministry. He allots different administrative portfolios to ministers. He takes care of the work carried out by every minister and guides him. He lets the governor know about the decisions of the cabinet. He shuffles the ministry according to the requirement as he thinks fit. The ministry decides policy relating to the subjects assigned to state government and execute them. Ministry presents bills in legislative assembly. Minister of Finance presents budget in legislative assembly. At the level of state, the state government functions and for the nation, union government or central government functions. There are 28 states and 7 provinces governed by central government in India. The function and powers assigned to central government and state government are divided into 3 lists: union list, state list and the cabinet list. There are 97 subjects in the union list based on which the union government frames laws. There are 66 subjects in the state list based on which the state government frames laws. There are 47 subjects of cabinet list based on which both the state government and the union government frame laws. Marina Imran and other students of the school were very excited about their trip to Gandhinagar, the capital of Gujarat, where they were going to see the legislative assembly. After the security check, they went upstairs. There were arrangements made for visitors from where they could see the grand hall downstairs. Seating arrangements for the members of the legislative assembly was made in that meeting hall. On that day, a current issue was to be discussed in the legislative assembly. Usually in a legislative assembly, the MLAs can express their views during a question answer session. They can ask questions and give suggestions. The members give their feedback on the issues being discussed. Then the concerned ministers answer the questions and brief them about the measures being taken to solve the issue. We often come across on television or in newspapers, the decisions are taken by the chief ministers and other ministers in order to run the government. कई बार हम लोग टीवी पे देखते हैं कि जो चीफ मिनिस्टर्स होते हैं वो कैसे गवर्नमेंट का decisions लेते हैं. While taking a decision about anything, it is necessary to take the permission of the MLAs. In a democracy, the MLAs can question the chief minister and the other ministers and discuss about important matters. They can even take decisions regarding financial matters and decide on the expenditure to be done in different areas. When the legislative assembly is in session, any of the MLAs can ask questions. The speaker manages the assembly and one requires his or her permission before presenting anything. During question hour, members of legislative assembly can express their opinions in the house. They can ask questions or related subjects. They can also make suggestions on what the government should do in the respect. Then the minister related to the portfolio answer the question and explain whether necessary actions are being taken or not. For the management of the cabinet, the MLAs elect one member as the speaker and another as the deputy speaker. For any kind of presentation, the permission of the speaker of the deputy speaker is to be sought. Every MLA makes his presentation only by addressing the speaker or the deputy speaker.